All right, what is up, guys? So I hope you're enjoying quarantine. Might be a good time to get caught up on your model kit building, unless you're like me and you still have to work full time in the general public, which is always lovely. So I've been a little bit busy with that and with finishing up some other videos for the other channel, some of which I'm incredibly proud of. I finished a video that took months and months and months to make on the other channel. So now that's out of the way, I do have, as I've been saying, a couple of Zoids reviews still in the backlog, and this is one of the ones I've been very excited to do. So I mentioned how I bought a bunch of kits off of, well, not a bunch, I bought three kits off of a guy on the Zoids Collectors group, and the first one was the Bladelogger Shadow Impact. The other one is this right here, the Race Tiger. So I'm very excited about this one because, as you guys may or may not know, this was the sort of protagonist ace Zoid for Zoids Versus 3, the video game, which I loved pieces. I've done the Let's Play of it. You guys should definitely check that out and watch it if you haven't already. It's a couple years old now, but it's still one of my favorite Let's Plays I've ever done and some of my favorite Zoids content that I've ever made. In talking about the Race Tiger, I need to talk about Fusers and the Three Tigers story, which is part of the Battle Story spinoff. This was released in 2004 as part of the Fusers line in Japan. It was never released in the US. And it is, like I said, part of the Three Tigers story. So the Three Tigers story is a spin-off of the Battle Story, and these kits actually came with a little DVD that would show animation of the Zoid, as well as a story booklet, which mine did not come with. Mine didn't come with the box. It was just the kit and the instruction manual, which I do appreciate the fact that he still had that. But even if it did come with the Battle Story booklet, I wouldn't be able to read it because it's all in Japanese. But essentially, the Three Tigers storyline is the furthest point out in the future in the Battle Story timeline. So what's going on in that storyline is you have two Zoids manufacturing companies that were initially trying to resurrect old Zoid cores of ancient Tiger-type Zoids. And so you have Z-Arms, which ended up bringing back the Decalto Dragon and the Brastyle Tiger, and you have Zoitech, which brought us the Race Tiger and the Wits Tiger, which I also have and will be doing a review of soon. The Race Tiger was the protagonist Zoid in Zoids Versus 3 and was extremely powerful in that game, and you got it at the very beginning of the storyline, and you could easily just blow right through the entire campaign if you continue to use it. So in my Let's Play, I deliberately held off on using the Race Tiger until the end of the campaign just because of how powerful it was. So we'll go ahead and talk about it in terms of the how it functions. So it has in terms of weapons, it has the three-barrel shot cannon underneath here. It has pinpoint lasers off to the side here, and then it's missing the actual piece for this. Like, what you would see in the video game is not here on the actual kit, but there would be a weapon up top here called the laser nest, which was incredibly powerful. And one of the other characteristics of the Zoid, which is characterized by the sort of neon green color in the game and the glow-in-the-dark pieces here on the kit, is it has an ability similar to like Black Panther from Marvel, where the armor will absorb kinetic energy and then release it out sort of as a overcharge energy blast, which is not something you could actually do in the video game, but it is a really cool feature. It also has claw weapons and something called the Explosion Bite, which is something that can apparently incapacitate even large-type Zoids like Gojalus or Iron Kong with a single strike. So this thing is incredibly powerful, and it's a shame we never got to see this in action, any anime storyline or anything like that. I feel like a little OVA spin-off of the Three Tigers story would be pretty interesting to watch. This Zoid also has a fuser companion called the Terror Race, and that does fuse with it and become the piece that sits up top here. You can see the pegs for it. And I guess that's what the laser nest would be if you were to have the Terror Race. Of course, I do not. And it does not exist in the video game. You just have the complete Race Tiger with a weapon that sits up top there that doesn't really bear that much of a resemblance to the Terror Race. So I think they just kind of took pieces off of that and sort of made that weapon without it. And that pretty much does it for the Race Tiger in terms of the storyline. I think I went through that a little fast, but there's not all that much to say. If you guys want to read up on the Three Tigers story, feel free, but the problem is that there's very limited information available with it because there was no anime with it. It wasn't released very mainstream, so we're really dependent on people who can translate it from Japanese to English and then provide us with that information online, which is kind of a shame. But onto the model kit itself. So this is really the first opportunity we have to show off some of the Fusers era Zoids. So one of the things that's noteworthy about it is most of the head constructions on the older Zoids were sort of a clamshell thing where you had like several halves of pieces that combined together like that. This is not the case with the Fusers era Zoids, so they are simply just a head that can pop off, if the head will do that without breaking anything. It'll be easier to show this on the Wits Tiger, but the head is just... Okay, I'm not going to force it. But it's just on there on a single peg. The head is not just one piece, but it's just on there with a single peg that pegs into the torso. And what this gives is a nice, very proportionate body style for this. It looks like a real animal. Like, it looks like a tiger or something would look. It doesn't have a freakishly large head, which if you look at something like the Wild Liger or even like the Blade Liger, it does kind of have a disproportionately giant head, but that was something that we were just kind of used to seeing with Zoids in order to create the cockpit. Speaking of which, it does open up top here, and it does have the pilot in there. Amazing. Is that a regular Android pilot? Yeah, he's just upside down. And the jaw opens and closes without the motorized function. So the motorized function does not interact with the head in any kind of way. The feet also are kind of loose, similar to what the Wild Zoids would do later, and it does have these, the way the claws attach is pretty interesting as well. It has these interesting fiber optic tubes that go across the spine of it, so that's something I thought was really interesting. And if I had built this raw, like if I had just gotten the raw pieces or a sealed version of this kit and built it that way, I would have seen how these tubes attach, but it shows a depiction of it in the instruction manual, how you sort of wrap these tubes around these grooves around the body of the Zoid. And that's a really nice touch. I hope they don't deteriorate over time, and I hope that they stay in good condition, because it is a really cool feature, and it does add an interesting look to it, almost like it's got energy or maybe some kind of fluid running through it. A very unique aesthetic that a lot of other Zoids don't have. But the Fusers era definitely has a very simplistic build design that's kind of meant for greater accessibility. The switch on the back here is just a simple left and right switch. The tail does have a little bit of articulation on a hinge right there, nothing too special. And of course, I don't have the batteries in to demonstrate the motorized function. But really quick, I think I want to show off the glow-in-the-dark and show you guys how that looks. Oh wow, that actually shows up way better than I thought it would. That looks really cool, actually. It's the first time I'm seeing it like fully lit up like that. One of the things that struck me kind of odd about this when I first got it is I was like, this doesn't look like the same color scheme I'm used to from the game. And honestly, all that it was because these pieces were just translucent instead of green, and it was because on the actual model kit, they had converted that to a glow-in-the-dark feature, which, like I said, does look really cool. So when you see it like this, it does look exactly the same as it does in the game, because this was the only ever version of the Race Tiger ever released. I'd also like to point out how cool it is that it comes with its own stand that says Race Tiger on it. I think that's pretty cool, and how it fits on there is pretty simple. There's just a peg on the bottom like that that fits in like so, and just sits on its own little stand just like that, which I think is awesome. A lot of the Fusers era Zoids had that apparently, and I think there was something similar for even the Genesis line, like the Murasame Liger and things like that had a similar stand. So that is probably going to do it for this review of the Race Tiger. I really, really like this kit a lot. It doesn't have a whole lot of like features or moving parts. It's very simple. I think the primary gimmick of this era was, of course, the Fusers gimmick, where you had another smaller Zoid to link up with it. But that being said, I still like it, mainly for its look and for the storyline significance behind it. So very happy to have it. And I definitely want to track down the Brass Style Tiger as well. And then I'll have all three of them. The Decalto Dragon is cool, but I don't know that I'm super crazy about it. So if I see one in the wild, I'll definitely pick it up. But there's not a strong likelihood that I'll really go out of my way to find it. But the Brass Style Tiger I like a lot, so I'll definitely track that down. So, coming up next, we still have the review of the Beast Liger from Zoids Wild Zero, as well as the HMM Liger Zero and the Jaeger and Panzer Armors, respectively, as well, which will probably not be one singular video just because of how much there is to say from a storyline standpoint with the Liger Zero, but we're working on it. So I will be moving pretty soon. Michelle and I are still in the process of buying our new house, and the glass display case that my Zoids are in is the last thing that I want to move because I don't want to have to bubble wrap and package every single one of my build kits, especially the HMMs, because of how fragile they are. So that's part of the reason why I haven't built any new HMMs. Anything I've reviewed in the last 6-8 months or whatever has kind of just fallen into my lap. So when we get into the new house, I'm going to be building my backlog, which is going to consist of the HMM Red Blade Liger, Leon Blade Liger, the HMM Godos, HMM Cannon Tortoise, HMM Psychogenosaur, HMM Mulgas when they come in, HMM Great Saber, and let's see, the Gojulas Giga from Fusers that I found the couple weeks ago, and all sorts of stuff like that. So hope you guys are excited about that as I am, and definitely check out the Zoids vs. 3 Let's Play again. I will probably be streaming the Zoids vs. Trilogy again soon so that newcomers to the channel can see that, and so I can kind of give a new commentary now that I'm older, more experienced, have a new approach to videos, and, you know, time has passed and the Zoids community has kind of evolved and changed, so it's definitely a good time to go back and revisit those games, especially considering it was, like, what, 2011 when I first did Battle Legends, which would be Versus 2, so I definitely need to go back and play them again. So if you guys want to see that, let me know, and definitely subscribe to us on Twitch as well as the other channel if you guys are interested in, like, card game related content and other anime content. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time.